Hey guys, it's Nate here. Today I want to talk about how I prepare for data science interviews and the online resources that I've used in the past. So just a little bit about me. I've been in the field of data science for about 10 years. I've been a data scientist and I've been all the other flavors of a data scientist as well. You know, business analytics, growth analytics, marketing analytics, marketing science. These days though, I'm more aligned to product, but I still interview data scientists regularly. So as a data scientist and somebody that interviews data scientists, I know a little bit about how to prepare for the interview itself, and I know a lot about the topics that will be covered during the interview itself. So let's get started here. But before we do, please subscribe to this channel so that you can get more data science resources to help you with your career. So the first thing to understand are the different types of topics that are going to be covered during the interview. There are typically several different topics that are going to be covered during a data science interview. The recruiter should tell you what topics are going to be covered in that interview and what that format of the interview is going to look like. So for example, your first technical interview might just be over a video conference. Right, and so you're going to be sharing a screen with the interviewer where you can write and show your code to them. And your second interview might be in person, where you're meeting several data scientists and you're going through 4 to 5 different interviewers and covering 4 to 5 different topics. So it's really important to understand what all of those topics are so you can prepare sufficiently to succeed in those interviews. So for the most part, there are 4 topics that are covered in the data science interview. The first one is coding, then there's product sense, business cases. The third is statistics that can also include probability and that can also include Bayes' theorem as well. And then the final topic could be modeling, where they'll cover models like random forest, gradient boosting, k-means clustering, and several other common models out there. So question to you guys, have you encountered other topics in your data science interviews? If so, please leave what that topic is in the comments section of this video so that you can help other viewers like yourselves. So now that we know the 4 topics that are going to be covered in a data science interview, we need to prepare for them, right? So now let's talk about these 4 online platforms that I've used in the past to help prepare myself for these data science interviews and cover these 4 topics. And then at the end, I'll introduce one additional online resource that you guys can use to prepare for your data science interview. So now that we've introduced these 4 topics and know what's going to be covered in a data science interview, it's time to finally prepare for that interview. So there are 2 things I look for in a resource. 1, practice problems and lots of them. I want to practice as many problems as I can to reinforce all the concepts that are going to be covered in an interview. And 2, practice problems and interview questions that are very relevant for that interview and for that company. That's what I'm going to be looking for. So real questions that have been asked at interviews in the past, that's what I'm aiming to get. So here are 4 online resources that I've used in the past to prepare for data science interviews. And at the end, I'll introduce a 5th one to you all. So the first online resource is Glassdoor. It's actually one of my favorite platforms to use when I'm preparing for a data science interview. So I'm on Glassdoor right now. I typed in Facebook. I selected interviews from this menu here. So now if we scroll down to the middle of the page, we see interview questions for different positions at Facebook. So there's a data science one here that we're actually interested in. And then as we scroll down, we see other positions like front-end engineer, iOS developer, software engineer, but it looks like there are a lot of data science interview questions. And what I like about this is that these questions are real questions that were asked at the interview, right? And it's specifically at a data science interview at Facebook. So they're as real as they can get. The second thing I really like about this is that these questions cover all the topics that we discussed previously. This question covers statistics. And so if you actually then go down, this one is a coding question. And then as you go down more, there are other topics that are covered. So another thing that I do is if I'm preparing for a data science interview at Facebook, In addition to typing in Facebook and looking at all of the questions there, I'm going to search for other companies in the same industry as Facebook. So, you know, if I care more about social media companies, I might type in Snapchat or TikTok. If I want to kind of branch out a little bit, I might just type in, you know, other companies in the tech field. So Google would be another one. LinkedIn could be another one. So there are just a lot of interview questions and answers that you can get from Glassdoor. So now let's cover statistics and probability. I've used a website called brilliant.org. It's actually a math website. They also cover other types of topics like computer programming, computer science, quantitative finance, for example. But I use this to brush up on my statistics and my probability. This was also a website that Facebook recruiters recommended to get additional practice on statistics and probability. So here, like, all I do is I go to this practice part right here. There's a lot to choose from, but really what I care about most would be this probability selection right here. And if I go there, I have, you know, the fundamentals, and I have casino probability. Basically, I want to try, you know, as much as I can. And when I more or less dive into a lot of these practice problems, I'll kind of know whether or not they're going to be part of the data science interview. So on the Brilliant website, there are a few sections that I would recommend. So probability, definitely. Random variables, statistical testing, distributions is also another, a good way to cross-check whether or not you should be doing these questions is to go on Glassdoor first, read some of the statistical questions there, and then see whether or not those concepts are found on Brilliant. So this is what I would recommend. You know, this is one online resource to improve on your statistics and probability. But if you have another one, a better one that you would recommend, please leave that platform's name or website URL in the comments below so that others watching this video can also benefit from your knowledge. So online resources for modeling. So specifically machine learning models. I don't necessarily have one place I go to learn about machine learning models or brush up on those concepts. So on interviews, I've seen modeling questions come up in two ways. The first way is theoretical questions. The second way is when you talk about your projects. They indirectly or directly ask you about the models that you use and implemented on those projects. So let's talk about the theory first, right? So you could get questions on specific models such as random forests, gradient boosting, k-means clustering, and get questions on the models itself. You could get questions like, why would you want to use this model? Why wouldn't you want to use this model? How to implement this model in code, and how to read the results of this model and interpret the results. So those are most of the theoretical questions that you would get on modeling. Second, you could be talking about a project that used one of these models, right? And an interviewer could just dig deeper and deeper into the project itself and into the model itself and ask you questions about why you picked that model, what were some of the assumptions that you had while you were developing the model. So the point is, you really need to understand the theory about machine learning models. You don't need to know all of the machine learning models, but just the common ones. Okay, so a few websites I go to, a few online resources I go to, I tend to read blogs a lot. So Towards Data Science is a popular blog, a popular website that I go to, and they have a lot of blog articles on machine learning models. So in addition to these blog articles that I read to really brush up on my machine learning theory and understanding, I do go to YouTube to watch as many videos as I can, right? So there's a few channels that I would recommend, like Simply Learn and a new guy, Data Professor. They talk about machine learning models a lot. They talk about the theory, they talk about the application, and that's what's important. And so in addition to following some of these channels, I'll also just type in machine learning models and just search for as many videos as I can. So most importantly, if you have a recommendation on a better way to learn about modeling and machine learning models, please write a comment in the comment section of this video so that others, including myself, can learn from you. All right, now on to the coding portion of the interview. So the online platform that I used to use is called Leetcode. This is essentially a platform that was developed for computer scientists, for software developers to prepare for their interviews. But they have a nice little database section here where they have questions where you can practice your SQL. So if I click on, for example, second highest salary here, I will get a practice question where I can type in SQL code here and I can execute that code and it'll actually output something. So it's a fully fledged workspace and an IDE to practice my SQL queries. So what I like about this is that there are hundreds and hundreds of practice problems, practice SQL problems here. As you see, I can get really good at just improving my SQL and coding skills for the interview itself. The one downside I would say to Leetcode is, again, it is and was tailored for software developers. So a lot of these questions here really just help you get better at SQL, but they're not asking data science type of questions that deal with data. So then I would go to Glassdoor, try to find some coding questions for the company that I'm interviewing for to then understand what data science concepts are being covered in those coding questions, right? And so that I would learn off of that. And then if I just wanted to practice SQL, I would go to Leetcode and just try to answer as many questions as possible. So now for the fifth online resource that I promised you guys at the beginning. So this is StrataScratch, and it's a platform that I designed and built to achieve one thing, to help data scientists prepare for their interviews. So this is a platform that was built for data scientists, and it combines all the best parts of those four online resources that I was talking about earlier into one platform. So here we have coding questions, and you can select the questions based off of company. You can select questions based off of whether or not you're more comfortable with SQL or with Python. And then if you do want to click into one of them, you have the questions, you have the hint, you can see solutions as well as the solutions from other users. And so these questions are real questions that come from data science interviews, right? So you can be sure that what you're doing maps directly to a data science interview. So now if you go to non-coding questions, you essentially have technical questions of different question types. So you have probability, business cases and product sense type of questions. You have modeling questions, statistics, miscellaneous technical questions, and system design, right? So a lot of other concepts that would be tested during a data science interview. So if I double click into one of these questions, this one is a Facebook probability question. You get the question here, you get essentially an editor to be able to comment and provide your solutions, and then you get to see other users and their solutions. So across the coding and non-coding questions, there are actually over 1,000 interview questions here that are taken from real companies for you to practice on. So if you're interested in learning more, there's more information in the description in this video. So there you have it, 5 online platforms to help you prepare for your data science interview. I hope this is helpful. If you like this type of content, please subscribe to my channel here. Thanks.